and there's a unfortunately there's a couple. Okay, hold on. I don't know if these are all the songs, but that's okay.
Oh, just make sure all the albums are on there, you know? Oh, shit.
Or like, it's like all the albums are represented. It's every song.
No. Let's get a proper bracket.
Yeah, let's get a proper bracket, bro.
Go to
the... Man, that looks really good.
Huh? Yeah. Wait, can you, how do you move songs, though?
Let's see.
Oh, we have to create an account.
Alright. I got it, yeah.
Hey, man. Look at the spread.
Yo!
Alright.
You gotta make more, bro! The F-Wings, bro.
The F-Wings. So, welcome to the Kendrick Lamar Elimination Bracket. Currently, we have 83 tracks. In the
83 tracks?
83 tracks that we're putting in the hot seat.
Alright.
Wait, hold up. This looks really stupid, bro.
It's fine, bro. Just mutated chicken. Alright, bro. You gotta stop the music so we don't get copyrighted.
Wait, it doesn't matter if it's copyrighted.
It does, because it just blocks the video from you being posted.
Yeah, that's what happened to the other video.
Not on... Well, because we had way too many the last time.
Oh,
because I just uploaded it. It took like 7 hours to upload.
Wait, Loki, should I move the air fryer a little bit?
Fine, yeah.
Just
because... So I'm not like getting...
No. Just because, in case there's like a little buzzing sound. Then.
Yeah, good idea.
Where do you think I should move it?
Maybe... Right here. Yeah, put it right there.
Alright, wait, can you... I think you need to be close to it, bro.
Alright.
If
you want, I'll take this out. Oh, unless you want.
Alright.
Cool.
We can pass the
bird.
Yeah,
here.
Oh, I got you, bro. Here, David, here's your cup.
Thank you.
Right here. Alrighty.
Alright.
So. Guess who's back?
Back Guess again. I don't like Eminem. We're not doing an Eminem bracket, bro. But yeah, alright, so this is Kevin.
Hello, yeah. Kevin.
This is Jordan.
Jordan C.
Simir. I don't have a. No. Anyways,
My name is Migs, this is David, this is Coven.
Yes, sir.
We're doing the Kendrick bracket today.
We got 83 music, so we're gonna be, or songs, I mean.
83 music.
83 music, yeah.
83 M's, bro.
83 M's. So let's kick it off, let's get things started.
Let's kick it
off. Hey, we got some nice wings over here.
You see that, guys?
Damn.
Everyone cheers, everyone cheers, everyone cheers.
Oh, yeah, wait, one second. Cheers. I don't want the deformed one. All right, cheers, boys.
Cheers. All right, what's the first?
So the first would be Singing About Me Dying and Mama.
Oh. Sing About Me, I'm Dying.
Sing About Me, I'm Dying, but
Mama's a really good track. Yeah. It's the most one of the most underrated tracks and one of the most wholesome tracks. And
dude, it's one of the best Mama anthems for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck.
Shout out Hey Mama by Kanye West.
So, chapter 6 and Love.
Love?
Love, yeah.
I love, yeah.
But chapter 6 is a really... Damn, chapter 6 is a deep cut. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to rehear it, or...?
Let's get a refresher.
All right. Let's go, here we go. I like the sample a lot. The sample is really good. This part will get cut off. I'm still going Love.
I'm gonna go with Love too.
Yeah, Love is.
Love is like one of the coolest tracks on Dan.
And
I
it sounds so beautiful.
It's a beautiful track, man.
So sexy.
It gets way too much hate. It's
so sexy.
Yeah, and him doing it live is crazy.
Yeah, the security guard cried.
Oh wow, that didn't go. That didn't work.
Shout out to the AF.
Shout out to the AF. It's done, bro.
Let's see.
Woo!
All right, blow my high or fuck your ethnicity.
Fuck your ethnicity.
Yes,
I'm going.
Yeah,
fuck
that's the better song on.
Blow my high is good though.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
I feel like the end of section 80, like
so it's perfect.
I disagree, but
oh wait, no. I just think the last song is perfect.
So next would be Father Time or Keisha's song.
Father Time.
Keisha's song is.
Father's Time is arguably like the best song in Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers.
Yeah,
arguably.
See that? Yeah.
But Santa is like amazing on it.
So. He's grown so much in section 80 to.
I think introspective wise, lyrically, I think that's one of his deepest cuts. Okay. So, you know.
I might need a refresher here, but Untitled One in Blood.
I got you.
It starts off and the dude's like, come here, baby. Yeah, suck on that dick. And then. No, like, actually, it's talking about.
Actually,
sex.
No, it starts off like this.
I told my boy to roll like 10 blunts for me. Not at all.
I'm just kidding. Anyway, I'm talking about one. Here we go.
The intro is like really long.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll just skip through it. I'll probably go this. I mean, Blood's just the intro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're going Untitled One. Blood is a cool intro, though.
Blood's kind of annoying, in my opinion. I don't like the reversed
Hello. Music. Hello. A blind woman.
A blind woman.
Shout out Matt Murdock.
Matt Murdock.
He's blind.
He is blind.
You know who else is blind? Anyway.
Who, actually?
I don't know.
Oh, Kane from John Wick 4.
Yeah, dude. That guy was goated.
Drake is blind. I think he's blind.
I hope so.
You think he's blind?
I don't think so, bro.
Man, he's blinded.
Are you blind?
I mean, like...
Because you're Drake.
Oh, what?
Alright, let's go.
Alright, the Black or the Berry or Mortal Man?
Ooh! The Black or the Berry.
Ooh, do you need a refresher?
Yeah, dude, I'm growing.
Okay, cool.
Refresher for everything.
I'm the biggest hypocrite of 2015! It's the Black or the Berry. The sweeter the juice.
Black.
I'm probably gonna go black.
But I think Mortal Man's really good. I'll skip to the chorus, bro. You got it?
Yeah.
Here's Mortal Man. It's a 12-minute song.
Wait, but you forgot. He has a song about celebrating February like it's his birthday.
It is.
Still a fan. I mean, he touched his keys.
Are we good?
Cool. Probably right. Black or the Berry.
I'm going to the Black or the Berry.
Yeah.
But let's not discount Mortal Man. Like, I think every single Kendrick song is too fucking deep to just, like...
That's a top five song on T-Pad.
Mortal Man?
I think so, man.
I don't know.
Dude, I love the Tupac. Dude, I still remember the first time I heard it, and I heard the Tupac at the end, I was like, mind-blowing. I like it a lot. It's a very personal song. It's a great song.
At the very end, he combines the whole poem together. I remember you was conflicted, misusing your influence. Sometimes I did the same, abusing my power.
Hey, do you celebrate February like it's your birthday?
Yes, bro, and I eat watermelon chicken and Kool-Aid on weekdays.
Oh, yeah.
When shit hits the fan...
My nose is round and wide. You hate me, don't you? You hate my people!
Why are you rapping like Tyler, the Creator?
That's what he sounds like on the Black of the Berry. This one of the juice. Black of the Berry.
Okay.
Sorry. That's quick. I think Mortal Man is a weaker cut on To Pimp a Butterfly because it doesn't have, like, the
I think the Black of the Berry is kind of like an anthem.
Yeah, exactly.
To be honest.
Mortal Man doesn't have like the sonic elements I'm looking for. It's very, very story heavy, which is not a bad thing, but it's just...
Yeah, I feel like if you're more into the story, then you'd probably pick Mortal Man.
Yeah.
But I think the Black of the Berry, it's like sonically, like the production...
What he's talking about. The subject matter is, he's the biggest hypocrite of 2015.
What do you got to think of?
I think Black of the Berry sounds better.
Okay.
Shout out Redville.
They both have deep cuts, but...
Facts. What's next?
Mr. Morale or Absol's outro?
Mr. Morale.
Mr. Morale, give me high five.
That's
kind of
Pharrell. Okay. Yeah, that one.
Okay. But we also have... So Absol's outro is one of the...
No, that's a good song.
I think it's Absol's like best performance on any feature. Maybe not.
You guys want to review?
It's really good. Absol's... Oh my god, it's really good.
Right here.
It's kind of tough for me.
I'm still going Mr. Morale, but... Just because, I don't know. Wait, let's... Here. Comes like the drums, man.
Mm-hmm. Really get it. I might have to go for Absol, just for
how... Let's skip around.
We see our sax, man.
Alright, then here's one. Mr. Morale.
So this is tough.
Hey, shout out Pharrell, best producer ever in hip hop. Ever.
This is tough for me.
But that's okay. For me too.
Because,
yeah, it is tough.
Given my jazz background, the Absol's outro.
See, I think Absol's outro is like, I think it's a Butterfly before it's been Butterfly.
Yeah. I feel like production wise, if we're talking production, as much as I love Pharrell, I do love the jazz that he brought there, like
it's
the drums.
Perfect. And then they're just spitting over it. So it's like two parts of black culture fusing together. You've got jazz, you got rap.
And I do like Mr. Morale, man. It's like one of his like most, I mean, as a lot of the album is, very introspective. I think he's like, I'd argue that he's a better rapper. This rapping performance was probably better in Mr. Morale. Like,
really?
I mean, I feel like it's more because he was like more polished, I'd say. But let's make the viewers mad. Let's go Absol's outro.
Yeah. Is it more polished though? Because like, he knew exactly what he was doing.
on
he did.
Section 80.
No,
he
I mean,
was like
he,
a
he
kid
just,
hungry for like.
That is true,
bars.
But he's just like a little more grown, you know. He's like more to think about, more to say.
That's true, but I feel like at the same time, some of the subject matter on Mr. Brown and the Big Steppers isn't as deep as it was compared to like Section 80.
That's true.
He's like opening his mind to new things that have kind of already been there, and I guess he's stepping out of his own comfort zone.
Good point.
But, like. I think Section 80 he's talking about.
Let's go Absol.
Anyways, let's go Absol. Hell yeah. Hell fucking yeah.
Only been 9 minutes.
What
we got? So, King Kunta, Good Kid
King
Mad City.
Kunta. Oh, wait, what?
Good Kid Mad City?
Oh, that...
Wait, I fucked up.
Oh,
it's just Good Kid.
No, I fucked up because I wrote...
You wrote
Mad City? I wrote the album name.
Which is mean Good Kid.
So there's no, because I did write.
But did he put Good Kid?
I did write both Good Kid and Mad City. Like,
oh wait,
separately.
Where's the other
so
one?
So I,
death, bro.
Did I not write? Did I actually just? I think I could have swore.
You know what?
No, it wasn't. I could have swore.
Oh, Good Kid. Yes, Good Kid.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Good Kid is here.
Yeah.
Okay, fine. So we'll just call this one Mad City then.
This is just my like as you're saying words, I just
oh,
kept typing.
Okay, well fine. Alright, well King Kunta is definitely better.
Then what?
Then Good Kid Mad City. Because it's not a song.
It's an album though. It's an album.
Okay, we'll let it go through.
Put King Kunta up.
Yeah. King Kunta's a great
song. King Kunta's go awesome, yeah.
Yeah, but it's not going against anything, so just yeah.
It wins. Yeah, it keeps going.
Well King Kunta's like one of the GOAT songs. I mean I like the
I got a bone to pick.
I don't want you monkey mouth motherfucker sitting in my throne again.
Okay. I'm mad.
Okay, I don't know
but
how
I am stressing.
Okay, complexion or count me out? This is tough.
Wait, what's complexion or count me out?
Yeah.
Wait, count me out or what?
Complexion.
Oh, shit.
So,
Espro.
Count me out was my favorite song in.
Oh, really? I think it's top three for me, too. It's really good on Mr. Robinson.
Yeah, it's top three for me, too.
I think complexion's only cut on...
Yeah,
To Pimp.
But what if it was on Mr. Mal and the Big Steppers? It'd be like,
well, duh. but that's not how it is.
Yeah, but yes, I do. Shout out to Rhapsody because your verse has made me cry before.
Rhapsody is in
that her voice. That verse made me cry before, man.
Dude, the switch, bro. Complexion.
Especially, it's complexion, like it's, you gotta be comfortable in your own skin, man. Be comfortable in your own skin because
that's what it's about, honestly.
Be comfortable in your own skin because that's. All you got. I mean, that's what you got. You're going to be thankful for.
I don't want to discount your favorite song.
But it's going to be... It's Count Me Out, though. It's Count Me Out.
It's Count Me Out.
I love when you count me out.
The music video. Wait, come on. You're like kind of covered by the air fryer.
Oh, shit, am I?
Yes, bro.
Yes, bro. Hey, what's up?
It's been like 10 minutes. Okay.
No, it's cool. It's cool. I used to be that, right?
Maybe you can scoot in a little more.
Maybe.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, it's Count Me Out. It's Count Me Out.
All right.
I hope you'll count me out.
Yeah.
It's Count Me Out. It's Count Me Out.
Uh-huh.
It's Count Me Out.
All right.
What complexion. It's really... Oh, thank you. Really hard picking Kendrick song, bro.
Yeah, Kendrick is too many good songs. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so... Lust, Mother, I'm Sober.
Martin Luther by Unimals.
Indiana Jones by
Indiana Jones.
I go less.
I got a four-wheeler.
I don't know that song. Do you guys need to... Dude, Unimars sucks. He's on that song. Unimars, he's like, he raps like this.
Christ.
And chat, let us know if you want a Unimals tier list or bracket.
All right, we'll do it. Unimals. Yeah.
We'll do Unimals then.
Shit.
Wait,
can we get a refresher on Lust?
I'm picking Lust.
I need some water.
I'm picking Lust.
Stuff to get it over me.
I just...
Way too.
Dude, the production is crazy too, man.
It is really good, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And the Mother Eyes Sober, though.
I come back to Lust a little more, but okay. This will probably get good. Wake up in the morning, think about money, kick your feet up. Watch your comedy, take a shit and roll some weed. Go hit a lick and go fuck on a bitch. Go to work today, cop you a fit or maybe some kick that.
Yeah. But then Mother Eyes Sober goes like...
Yeah.
All right, let's play Mother Eyes Sober.
Play Mother Eyes Sober, yeah.
Yeah, this is not an easy pick, man. Mother Eyes Sober is a great song.
It's, I think... The deepest cut on all of Mr. Brown.
Isn't it your top three?
It's not in my top three, but it's maybe top six.
Top six.
No, yeah, like the lyrics, lyrical content is like. So listen close before you start to pass judgment on how we move, learn how we cope. Oh, okay, guys, what are we thinking? What are we thinking, boys?
I like Mother Eyes Sober, man. I
you
gotta
like Mother Eyes Sober?
And the leaks, like, okay. Kendrick didn't make an album from 2017 to 2022, excluding the Black Panther shit.
Mm-hmm.
And. In those 5 years, only like 3 or 4 songs really got leaked. And I think Prayer was one of them.
Oh, was prayer like supposed to be like interpolated into this?
Exactly.
Oh, no, prayer is like, I was born in February, like where he was pretending to be like fucking Jack. Yeah, I like that song a lot. Exactly. So it got interpolated this. I did not know that actually.
I wish I was somebody, anybody.
Was that in prayer?
I think it was, no, maybe it was in the other one. I forget what
it was. Was it where the earth is just a rock without the voices of art?
What's that one?
And actually, that's the same song. But no. Okay, wait. Okay, what are we going for?
What do you think, Coven?
Cause okay, here.
This is a tough pick, man.
So Mother of Sober is more of like a deep cut. It's more introspective, lyrical cut. But if you like the production
on Lust, yeah,
then Lust might be better. But Kendrick has kind of given all of himself up in Mother of Sober, whereas Lust is like kind of like just a portion of his mind.
And also Lust is like the reason that led up to Mr. Morale and the Big Steppers too. A big reason.
Lust, yeah. Lust is like,
I also just, I don't know, I think Lust is one of the weaker cuts on Damn for me.
Really?
I mean, I really like the production, right? But besides that, you know,
it's weaker for me. I think it was weaker for me as well. Okay.
Let's go Mother Eyes Sober.
Mother Eyes Sober?
Mother Eyes Sober. Let's go Mother Eyes Sober.
Mother Eyes Sober.
I think it's a good pick.
Hell yeah.
We'll give that a...
How about Father Eyes Sober?
How about Mother I'm Drunk?
Justin Bieber, shout out to him, man. I love your Christmas album. Please send it to me.
Call your friends and let's get drunk.
Can you send me the Justin Bieber Christmas album?
I don't have that album.
Esp.
Okay. Well, anyways, y'all continue with the bracket, and I'm gonna get some water.
All right.
So next in the bracket, we got Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe and We Cry Together.
Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe.
This is a tough pick.
We Cry Together.
This is a very tough pick.
Wait, are you serious?
I think Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe is like one of the weaker.
Dude, that's a classic.
It's one of my least favorites on Good Kid, Man. It's kind of annoying. But it's not like classic. Annoying in a bad. Oh man, I just said it's annoying. Shit. I didn't mean it like that. Bitch, don't kill my vibe. Kendrick's not as good
Bitch
at singing.
Bitch, don't kill
on
my vibe.
Kendrick's not good at singing on that. Hey. We Cry Together is such a unique track.
It's Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
Dude.
Come in.
Taylor Page is literally screaming her heart out.
What would you rather listen to?
We Cry Together.
You're on a date.
Yeah.
Would you rather play We Cry Together and be like, hey, look, this can be us, babe.
Yes.
or do you want to chill, like, and just like, Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe and just like, just enjoy. It's a classic.
Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe is a passive aggressive way of saying.
Let's use like, point. Play a little snippet of We Cry Together.
Just a little snippet.
Man, fuck you, bitch.
Fuck you.
Wait, fuck you.
Can I play the clean version? I only listen
to play the clean version. Play the clean version. Yo.
It's man, I gotta go Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe, man.
I think We Cry Together.
Coven, dude, you're the tiebreaker.
In the kids pop version, that song sucks, dude. We Cry Together.
Yeah, but kids pop version, kids pop everything sucks, what bro. Do you mean?
But you know Bitch Don't Kill My Vibe, kids pop version?
Does it not suck?
Brothers Don't Kill My Vibe.
Alright. No, but like... Alchemist production.
Bitch, don't kill my vibe, dude. It's really? A classic.
I think it is a classic.
We
it's
Cry Together
true.
Is like, I think We Cry it's Together
okay. I'll be honest. Like, I always view We Cry Together as like a meme. It's like, I can't take the song seriously.
Yeah.
Really? It's like, it's,
no. Yeah, in the context, yes, I can take it. I can see your perspective of it being a meme. Yeah, go ahead.
But yeah, it's like, I just can't take the song seriously. There was barely any replay value with that song in
really?
Me. So I like... I think the worst was when I was trying to listen to the album, and then I was driving home with my dad, and then we're just listening to the song.
Man, fuck you!
And then, like, it was just like a good minute of that, and I'm like, this is shit, listen to dad. Thank you, dad.
Fine, okay, alright. That's why we have three people this time. Bitch, don't kill my vibe.
Yeah, because this guy has shit taste, bro. Alright, United in Grief or No Makeup?
United in Grief. No Makeup is one of his worst songs. United in Grief is my favorite.
Oh, United. I know, it's that one we're talking about the makeup. Oh, yeah, okay. It's United in Grief. And that's like one of his best intros, actually.
Oh, I think it's better than. Okay, it's not better than Wesley's Theory. It's not better than Terrain. It's better than Blood and DNA. And I think it's better than Fuck Your Ethnicity and Untitled One. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's third place.
Fear? And Compton.
Fear. Best song on Damn for me.
Compton's a weak outro for a Kendrick album, I feel like. Okay. But he worked with Dre, you know, it's a celebratory.
Here's my take. Compton, while it's not like the best song.
My microphone's over here, bro.
Oh, sorry.
No, get up closer because there is a microphone on the camera.
While Compton is not the best song, and it's not like the most like, you know, like traditionally like
I just feel like it's a nice like credit roll thing, you know?
Mm-hmm.
That's I agree. In a movie, like there's a credit. Because mm-hmm. Kid Mad City is a short film.
Mm-hmm.
At the end of the credits, like it's not always the best song, but it's always like a final song. Like I think it does it perfectly.
I agree.
It's not like, yeah, it's not like his best like outro or anything, but it's just like, it's a shout out to Compton, man. I love that song a lot, I'm sorry.
Alright. So we're voting for Fear.
But Fear's like, Fear, like, well, I'll talk about that later. And shout out to Alchemist produces too.
Yeah, Alchemist, they produced this one. Yeah. Shit, yeah. Right. There we go, fine. Okay, so Alchemist wins not with We Cry Together, but on.
Dude, yes, because Fear's a better song.
Than right. Compton, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
But
okay.
We Cry Together is, I like it better.
Cushion Corinthians.
Yeah, I'll
Corinthians, I spelled it wrong.
Cushion Corinthians,
yeah.
Element.
Oh, yeah.
They're gonna take me on that.
I might need
it. Wait, what's
the.
Good too, man.
You get this Republican song.
I lost one of my biggest beliefs.
You good? Yeah, we're good.
It's 2
a.m. I keep
place
forgetting
about to close. Be just the Chicago
I keep
saying that.
Yeah, like, I keep forgetting how like jazzy Section 80 is.
It is, mm-hmm. Yeah.
It's like the jazz rap album.
Mm-hmm. Before T-Pab.
Mm-hmm.
And after mm-hmm. all the tribe stuff.
I think Element.
Yeah, I still go Element.
Element's
though.
More iconic.
Mm. Element is just it's a bang. It's the okay. Hot take. I do like it more than DNA as like a banger. On
I know.
Really?
Okay. That's what's a hot take. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a hot take. I can tell if you're serious or not, though. That's
no,
I'm
sorry.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's okay, Davey Wavy.
Yeah.
I'm gonna vote against you guys.
What?
I do like Cushion. I don't even know how to spell. Does that say that a word?
Yeah. So
like
you don't even know the song, bro.
I don't even know the song. It just sounds better though.
You didn't even know the song.
I still. It's a 2-1.
Yeah,
I mean, fuck, I lost, dude. I'm sorry. Like, shit,
no, not.
Hey, we teamed up against the guy who's like supposed to like break us apart, bro.
Exactly. No, but I appreciate you.
Yeah, yeah. Wait to stand up. Like yeah, do your any.
Now, what do we got?
All right, Poetic Justice or For Sale?
For Sale. Interlude.
Wait.
Poetic Justice is better.
Yeah. Poetic Justice. Wait. Oh no, I was thinking about For Sale. I was thinking about For Sale.
That is For Sale.
No, for free. I was thinking for free.
Oh.
No. Poetic Justice. Mm-hmm. Hey, okay. Look, Drake was like the perfect feature for this, bro.
Drake.
No, like yeah, this yeah. is like okay. This is like serious me talking, bro. Like I think he like fit the song like perfectly. Like he slid. This is when Drake was cool, bro. When Drake was cool, bro.
Kinda.
Like he was like so mysterious and like
Drake was cooler. Song. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's never been that cool to be honest, because he's Drake.
Yeah.
Mm, but I agree.
What do you mean? Drake is the coolest dude on earth, bro. He created coolness, bro. He created.
He defined the cool genre.
He's a moon, bro. All right, next.
Wait,
X,
what was the other one? Oh wait, but we can't sleep on For Sale just like
For
that.
For Sale's good.
You know he knows the Bible too.
And when I get you, I'm gonna lie. Okay, institutionalized or XXX? Institutionalized for me.
Yeah, me too.
Okay. Shout out to the Snoop Dogs. We'll talk. I like this song a lot. Like, yep. Wait, do you want to refresh on it?
I need a refresher. I listen to XSX way
dude,
more.
Dude, listen to this song, bro. You're gonna. I just want to play this song for you.
You don't know these walls, bro. You gotta listen to this.
Listen to this. Hold on.
My money got to do with it.
Wait, listen to the beat drop. The beat drop is so nice. This is one of the songs like I want to play out. This is one of my favorite songs on T-Pab actually.
Yeah.
Thanks, Chase.
Right.
Okay. A box of chocolate.
Okay, I think I'm convinced.
Bro, something for something.
Okay, I just really like the song.
Yeah. Shit, the song. Don't change until you get up and wash your ass,
brother.
Brother?
Wait, did he mean to put you four or like you?
What?
Oh, I've been like fast typing this shit, dude.
Oh, you?
Yeah.
Okay, so you or loyalty? It's you.
Yeah, dude, loyalty's. Okay, loyalty's actually annoying.
Loyalty's pretty
annoying.
Yeah.
And you is. Ah! One of his best.
Oh, songs. No shit.
What
no,
did
no.
you do?
Okay, no, so these are untitled four. Sorry.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
I just wrote you.
Yeah, but I'm not telling for. Oh, that one.
I want a reminder.
I do like it better than loyalty, though. Yeah. That's for sure. This one's good.
I'm so hungry, bro.
Oh, this song.
Yep.
Yeah, I don't really like Loyalty, dude.
I don't like Loyalty either. Like that, and Untitled 4 is...
I didn't even have to listen to... Loyalty is like one of my least favorite Kendrick tracks.
Exactly, that's what I'm talking about. No, but...
I'll listen to Loyalty, but it gets a little annoying, man.
Okay.
ADHD
Untitled 4. I'm like living like 5 minutes in the past, guys. I still haven't even processed Poetic Justice. But okay, Untitled 4 is like an interlude track basically on Untitled the Master. But it sounds like it, like an Isaiah Rashad and SZA song is what I wanted to say. Yeah. ADHD, bro. But Untitled 6 is
I gotta go Untitled 6, man. Wait, hold on. Jazzy. Look, listen to this. You just gotta hear it, man.
A mic? Gemini,
duality, personalities always conflicted. I think it's ADHD for me.
It's ADHD?
Oh my god. Dun, 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 dun.
It's a little bit more relatable with me, so.
Oh, okay. Because you have ADHD, right?
Yeah. Fuck god. Hey, doobies to the face. Fuck.
I don't know if I can vote for a song that says fuck god, actually. Just kidding. These are probably equal, in my opinion. It's like really hard to pick between them.
I'm going on 12-6.
Okay.
So make the decision.
But to be honest, I don't care who goes by. I like both songs like pretty equally. I just want to be that. I want to be the edge, bro. Like, okay. Untitled 6 is so good.
I think ADHD is more like... overplayed, which it's fine. But it's overplayed for not as good of a reason as Untitled 6 is
underplayed.
Yeah, exactly.
Right? Dude, it's so jazzy.
I know.
It's true. I do like Untitled 6.
Yeah, sorry about that.
No.
We had to go, yeah.
And
you
do
like Section 80, huh?
Yeah, I do.
You really
like
Section
80? Yeah.
Pride versus N95.
N95, yes.
No question, bro. One of his best bangers. Dude, seeing that shit live is crazy.
Dude, I saw Pride live too. N95 when he does United Grief, and then a fucking fire comes out.
Yeah, in Blog Now, dude, it was like fucking fireworks, bro.
Hello, new world, all the boys and girls. I got
When you first heard Mr. Morale and Big Steppers, what was your first thought about N95?
It sounds like a drill song.
I loved it, bro.
I loved it so much. I was like, this is the banger I'm calling it, and then people just blew it up on TikTok. So
Dude, it's better than a lot of the bangers of
for sure.
I think Mr. Brown, right. I like Humble, but I like Mr. Brown, Big Slipper is one of his best albums.
So, boys, we'll be reaching the second part of the bracket.
Already? Right? No way.
So, I guess part two of the bracket adds more tracks.
Yeah, cool, because
let's start from the bottom, Kevin.
Let's do it, yeah.
Start from the bottom?
Now we're here.
All right, so we're
you,
start
it's
from you.
Real versus you. Real is kind of annoying.
I'm real.
I think really, really. The reason why you don't like Loyalty is the reason why I don't like Real.
And the reason why I don't like, yeah.
That's fair.
Yeah. No, that's exactly it. You is arguably his best song. Yeah, arguably,
I agree. And Real is arguably one of his worst songs. There we go. That's
stinky.
Real is the only reason why Big Kid, Mad City is not better than To Pimp a Butterfly. In my opinion, if Real wasn't there, I think they're neck and neck. But that's the only thing, pushing it away. Anyway.
But To Pimp a Butterfly doesn't have Drake.
All right.
Oh, fuck, you're right. Oh, so maybe Good Kid, Mad City's better
than
Drake. All right. let's put Real up there.
All
right. Ooh, Kev the Boyo.
Oh, it's you.
It's you.
Do you remember you?
Come on. It's you.
No.
All right, we'll give you a refresh later.
He goes
loving you is complicated.
Oh yeah, that song.
I really like the second part.
She's like,
the reason why my mom and I'm leaving. Ooh. Now you ain't S.
You in FaceTime instead of the hospital visit because you thought he would recover well. Third surgery cut and stop the bleeding for real.
Have you seen the music video to that song?
Yeah,
God is gangster.
Crazy, yeah.
Dude, my God.
He's dying.
All right, there we go.
If there's
holy shit, yeah, you is, I think it's like you and These Walls are my favorite songs.
All right, next,
Crown or
N95, no question. Crown is good, but N95 is just like so much better.
All right,
next one will be
Die Hard or
you gotta click N95 though.
Sorry, go up. Yeah,
Die Hard versus All Right.
It's Die Hard, boys.
I had to. All right.
Are you dumb?
Doesn't Die Hard have You Know Miles on it?
Oh, that's true.
You're right.
I'm just kidding. It's all right, man.
It's all right, yeah.
We gonna be all right. I think All Right is also arguably one of his best songs. His best song.
I think it might be my favorite To Pimp a Butterfly, actually.
Yeah, you can't go wrong with
All It's also one of my go-to karaoke songs.
Because, like, Die Hard's good, but, like, it's just, like, a poppy funk song. You
know?
A funk song, sorry. A poppy song that's
All Right was, like, it had, like, a cultural impact.
Exactly. You see people at, like, Black Lives Matter rallies chanting, "We gon' be all right." And that came from Kendrick. That's crazy.
Yeah, yeah. All right. Crazy. Next would be The Art of the Peer Pressure and...
Untitled 6?
Untitled 6.
The Art of Peer Pressure. They made a left, and then a right, and then another right.
For which one?
Hey, there's somebody in this room!
Art of Peer Pressure?
Also do Untitled 6, yeah.
Everybody.
Here, I'll go to the middle.
Everybody, sit your bitch ass down and listen to this.
So this song, they're talking about, like, doing a robbery. In a...
Alright, now do Untitled 6, huh?
Here, let's like come in. I'll be the mediating
thing. I'm picking Untitled 6.
Wow, The Art of Peer Pressure, bro. Better storytelling, really, really cool intro. Yeah, I don't know. The Art of Peer Pressure, I think, like, underrated track.
Here, you guys duke it out for a little.
I can't duke it out any further than this. Okay, like.
Because I already have my answer, but one of you guys can sway me.
The interludes in The Art of Peer Pressure is also really cool too. Okay. Because, so his mama calls, he's like, "Shit, I'm just kicking it with my homies. But I'm actually about to catch my first offense," because he's with the homies. They evade the cops, all right? And then they're like, "All right, guys, we're going to split up." And then they're like, "Hey, K-Dot, you can go fuck on Shireen."
So, I guess like the story in The Art of Peer Pressure is pretty cool, I would say. Yeah. I like the beat in Untitled 6. It's once again catering to my tastes.
That is true. Untitled 6 has a better beat.
Yeah,
it's so jazzy.
It's kind of like for music with me. Like, I think that's like relatively my priority.
Okay, that's
I think
fair.
For you, like, it's a lot of like lyricism, the story.
Yes, but I think the atmosphere of The Art of Peer Pressure really like amplifies the setting. It sounds like you're scared to death, and what you're gonna do is just like
I'm picking The Art of Peer Pressure.
You're just like. Zoned out, and you're only focusing on nothing but like your heartbeat and your footsteps, and that's what like the
the golden hour is on me, bro.
All right, so
The Art of Peer Pressure. I'm going The Art of Peer Pressure.
Because I knew I heard him say.
I'm going The Art of Peer Pressure. Right, it's a very iconic track.
Sorry, Kevin.
It's one of his like storytelling tracks. It's just so iconic.
Sorry, Kevin.
He made a left. He made a right. And then another right. Yeah, okay. All
right, I or Untitled 4.
He gets the fuck out Shireen after. Sorry.
Sure ain't even that bad though. I think I'm cuter than Sure. It's I versus U4. Untitled 4.
I love myself. Untitled 4 is like the interlude one. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And I also just love the album version vibe.
Dude, and then it gets all funky.
Yeah.
We brought like both versions. No one but the number one rapper in the world. He done travel all across the world to play that.
Alright, so we hit the 18-minute mark.
Fuck. I can't say that word.
You can't.
What are you gonna say?
Fuck.
David, what are you gonna say, bro?
Fuck.
F.
I told my buddy Dave I never used the phrase fuck. He said, "Think about what you're saying. Fuck."
Bro, David, you gotta chill, bro.
Sorry.
Because, you know why?
Why?
Because you know Miles, bro.
My back really hurts.
Oh, man. You need any help with that?
Also,
you listen to
this
a lot
hoodie,
of...
but it shrank in the wash, so I'm taking it off because it's really hot right now. Mr. Brown's a big stepper story.
Hey, I got the same shirt.
Fun fact, guys.
Dude, when I first met Coven, one of the first things we talked... Actually, dude, Coven, why don't you tell?
Nah, you tell.
You were the one who remembered me on Zoom, bro.
Oh yeah, so like I met this bitch on Zoom.
Yo.
I met this brother on Zoom. And
Kids Bob.
And yeah, this is for orientation, and this guy was like, "Dude, you know, I really love Kendrick Lamar. You know what? I would love to marry Kendrick Lamar." And turns out he was not lying. This guy really wanted to marry Kendrick Lamar. And
but unfortunately, Biba Doobie came along.
Unfortunately, he came along. And so when I met this guy actually in person, I was like, are you the guy who wants to marry Kendrick Lamar? I was like, yeah, dude. Oh, I'm the guy. Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. And I'm like, that is so true.
That is so true, oh, yeah. Shit. And I was like, damn, bro.
And you were like, me too.
Me too, I guess. I'm not gay.
S, bro.
She, bro.
S, bro.
H, bro.
R, bro. P. Okay.
All right, wake up your brain. It's the with first word of the game.
Yeah.
Cashback with everything you
okay.
buy.
Okay, hood politics or institutionalized?
Okay.
Hood politics.
Do you need a refresher?
Yeah, I do need a refresher.
Hood politics, bro.
I don't know, bro.
Oh, kid, I'll pick up the phone.
Pick up the phone, nigga. Every time I call,
I'm going to voicemail. This is a tough one. You said institutionalized is one of your favorites, right?
This is one of my favorites too, though.
Okay. It's hard to pick one. Wait, just wait for this part.
Mm-hmm. Call me off Shanika's phone.
Monkey noises, bro.
I've been that one. Boo. Boo. Knew all that you went to school with.
Boo.
Baby mama ain't your new bitch. Boo. Boo. We was in the hood. 14 with the deuce deuce. 14 years later, go hard like we used to.
All the dead homies.
I'm dead, homies.
I don't give a fuck about no politics and rap my.
Alright. All good, it's all good.
No, we're good. Democrips and Rebloodikins. That's a hard ass line.
It's a hard line, yeah.
Democrips and Rebloodikins.
This is his boo boo.
Wait, and once upon a time in the city, some divine, West Side Compton, this little nigga, he's 5 foot something. God bless the kid. Took his homies to the show, and this is what they said. What am I supposed to do when I'm looking?
Alright, I'm gonna be the mediator this one.
No, you're not. I'll be the mediator.
Can I be the mediator?
Okay, fine.
Thank you.
Because I like politics and you like institutionalized.
No, I don't know, bro.
Really?
That's why I want to be the mediator.
Oh, fine. Okay, what do you like, Kevin?
I like institutionalized.
Okay, so yeah, you'll be the mediator. Okay. But politics is actually really cool, too, because at the end, it's when, like, the biggest part but until mortal man of the poem gets put together, and there's a lot of, like, horn elements, like jazz elements that are, like, backing up the vocal performance of his poem. He's got really hard lines, you know? Talked about, hopped out the caddy, just got my dick sucked. You can't go wrong with that, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But he talks about, like, Obama as president.
Okay.
He talks about what it's like to be, you know, like the hypocrisy of voting for a certain party when none of them really care about you because it's still white America.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's crazy. And he's talking about, like, so not just the politics of, you know, the U.S., but the politics within the hood, right? So, like, in the end, there's, like, this bigger overarching issue, but we're still stuck in the hood, messing with each other, and trying to, you know, kill each other. And
that's a good take. That's a good take.
And that's, like, a lot of good butterfly, yeah.
Come on, what do you got to say?
Yeah, I said, I'm saying words.
Institutionalized.
What do you like by institutional? You can talk about instrumental and stuff, or, like, production.
Get up.
I know you're big on production, so.
Yeah, you needed me to listen to this a bit more to, like, give you a proper answer. Is the small blink of institutionalized I did like it better. It did sound
so sonically you liked it better, like, well, why?
Yes.
Is that though?
Why is that though?
Yeah, yeah. What do you think?
Why did you like it a little more than Hood Politics?
I can't even give you an answer right now. I'm like, sorry if, like, the memory of that song is already out of my head.
I'll refresh it. Here, you do the drums.
All right, do drums, do the singing.
Oh wait.
And dude, like, the way he sings with it, I'm gonna be honest.
So you want institutionalized?
But institutionalized also is, like, another really, really big political take. That's crazy.
No, so what I was gonna say, actually, for the side of institutionalized, I think one, it's a very political take, but it's also a very personal take too. Like, what I remember watching a video essay about this, like, where being the institutionalized state in the metaphor of the butterfly to the is being in the cocoon. Mm. So when you're in the cocoon, you can't really like change or grow. I mean, yeah, you're still growing from the inside, but you're not getting out of your comfort zone. Unless you can get out of your comfort zone, like then, like you can do like anything once you get out of your comfort zone. You can be the butterfly people want, that people like so very, you know, like praise. Yeah. And I do feel like that definitely like relates to me a lot, like stepping out of comfort zone.
That's true. I mean, that's what we picked November, right?
I do like hood politics, but I think I gotta go institutionalized, man.
Yeah, it is
super close.
Wait, well, hold on. In hood politics, they go like,
yeah, but GT3 did it better.
Facts. Okay. Institutionalized.
Yeah. Good arguments. And Snoop Dogg, bro. Snoop Dogg just fucking slides.
Shit don't change.
Snoop Dogg, absolutely. Snoop. All right. I got you, bro. Can we do a three-way dip?
Next song would be Rigor Mortis. Or Untitled 8.
That's the last one, right? It's a bump. You want to listen to it?
Yeah.
Wait, do you remember Rick Morris?
I do remember Rick Morris, yeah.
Wait, okay. Wait, I'm just going to play like the first couple notes. And then I promise. I guarantee you, if I just play like the first couple seconds, you will already be like,
sweet. I said I'm out of my life.
I think I would imagine,
Is this your favorite on
Untitled the Master? I think so.
Mine's either 08 or 06.
Okay.
Yeah.
I like
but, here.
02.
Dude, blue faces, man. It's a double entendre with
money.
Why you? But you're still sad. Okay, what do you think, Cubby?
Let's hear Rigor Mortis real quick.
Oh,
Rusty.
Rigor Mortis.
Dude.
The horns already won me.
It's
issues. Yeah, the horns already won me.
Wait, for this?
Yeah, I love horns.
Really,
I am a horny cat.
Yeah. Okay, what do you gotta say? Actually, I'll start.
Yeah.
He's about to pop off with the story and the
No, I was gonna say, I think Untitled 08 is very, like, funky, very jazzy. Like, you can dance to it. I don't know. Like, that's the
that's
part.
That's fair, yeah.
I don't know if y'all seen the SNL live performance he did on it, but he absolutely snaps
Untitled
on
one
it.
With Lil Yachty.
Really good.
Yeah.
You're such a mood, bro.
SNL performance, right?
Shit. Yeah, anyway.
Well, that's the way. Performance is really good.
No. Like, I'd argue that his bars are, like, even, like when, especially when it builds up the end, I think his bars are, like, even, like, what, like, I argue that Rigor Mortis, like, he is, like, spitting for sure, like, and he's, like, spitting really fucking crazy,
super,
right?
Super fast, yeah.
But I feel like there, like, sometimes, like, this may be a take, but, like, sometimes, like, he's kind of just rapping to rap at the best. So, that's what it sometimes feels like, you know?
Like Eminem, right?
Or like, yeah. Or like, insane. That's not a bad thing necessarily.
Yeah,
I see what you mean. He's really trying to move himself at this point, right?
But he's like doing it so effortlessly, but it's like so hard on Untitled 08. But what are you going to say, Kevin?
Horns, they're awesome. Like,
And he raps like even better, I think, on Rigor Mortis.
Yeah.
He raps faster for sure. He raps like, yeah. Like, no, in terms of delivery and, like,
the Machine also spit on Rigor Mortis, and he, like, wow, he blew that shit out of the water. It's like, up there with Kendrick's. Like,
what
I don't
else,
know if anyone else
What else you gotta say?
I'll be honest, I don't have enough experience to listen to the entire Untitled tracks.
Amen.
To give you, amen.
He blessed.
He blessed.
I mean, Rigor Mortis is one of his most iconic songs.
Yeah.
Alright.
It's also,
I think, putting personal preferences aside,
in the essentially,
I think, Rigor Mortis is a better song.
Yeah.
And plus, Untitled 08's untitled and, it's unmastered.
I'm not mad about
Rigor
that.
Rigor Mortis is an actual song.
I'm not mad about that. Rigor Mortis.
Hell yeah.
I wish you performed that live.
Rigor Mortis, bro.
I wish you could perform that live more, bro.
Rick and Mortis.
Got me beating with dragons, like crack the egg in your basket. You basket,
Rick and Morty.
Man, dancing with madness. All right. Just imagine the madness. That's an acid. Don't ask for your rape, but rather he did.
See, you know,
justice or high power?
Oh,
just get the shit high power.
Wait, do you
know? I know what high power is.
And do you know poetic justice?
Everybody put three motherfucking
fingers in the air.
The sky is falling. Down.
Section 8, high power.
Visions of Martin Luther staring at me.
Wait, you know Miles' reference?
Oh, Martin Luther King.
But Drake is a poetic justice, bro.
No, okay, I don't know what's better, like, legit, though.
Drake or Uno Miles reference?
Mm. Oh, wait, let's put a serious faces on, bro.
Wow, this one, this is that one.
Dude, I'm
still
fucking hungry.
Yeah, just keep
going. Yeah, that's why we have a lot of food.
Thank you.
We got vegetables.
No, fuck that.
I'm gonna start eating some vegetables.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Big protein.
150 grams.
Of protein.
We got more.
Oh.
Oh, we do have more. Wait, are those for the air fryer?
No, these are cold.
Oh, you wanna just after the steak, let's heat them up, bro. Woo! Big veggie.
All right, fuck. Actually, I gotta get some veggies. I'm kidding.
Yeah, I know. It really hurts you if you just only eat meat.
Okay.
Look, the vegetables. Whoa.
Okay. Okay. High power is like that very defining moment in his career when Dr. Dre, The Game. Mm-hmm. Who else is there? No.
Oh, I think Snoop Dogg.
Snoop Dogg, they passed him the torch.
Yeah.
But poetic justice is a result of that torch passing. Okay,
it's
okay.
It's Good Kid, Mad City, you know what I'm saying?
It's like, just everything in Good Kid, Mad City is arguably just like so much better than...
I agree, yeah. Good Kid, Mad City is so much better than Section 80, but higher power, dude. Higher power. Oh, tap the screen.
If I told you that a flower bloomed in a dark room, would you trust it?
No, I wouldn't trust it.
You wouldn't trust it.
Mm. You guys want some celery or carrots?
I'll take carrots.
Oh, heck yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. You guys have a good one.
Yeah, we do.
Have a good day with you guys.
Thank you. Yeah. Go Tritons.
Go Tritons.
So I'm going to go...
I might go with high power.
Boy, just... justice, bro. You really like Section
80. Unfortunately, yeah.
No, unfortunately, it's a good pick. What do you mean?
You gotta be confident with your picks, bro. I'm going poetic justice. The only reason why I'm going poetic justice over high power is
Drake.
I think I really like the sample flip.
Oh yeah,
we have not even talked about the sample.
Janet Jackson.
Anytime, any place.
Oh, Janet Jackson.
I really like the Drake. I do like, unironically, I do love the Drake feature. Mm-hmm. I think it adds so much to the album.
With your big ass Nessa undress, kick out, woo!
And I just kind of wish Kendrick had more songs like this.
I agree.
Which
is why These Walls is also really, really fucking good.
It is a good song.
I think Poetic Justice is like one of his only, like, actually, he's got a lot of these on like all of his, at least one on every single album, right? He's got like his Keisha, I think it's Keisha's song, which is kind of like groovy. And then you have Poetic Justice, and then you have These Walls, and then you have Untitled. Actually, all of the Untitled ones are like that. And then you have Love. You know, like, they're all
about girls,
really,
bro.
Sexy, bro. Really fucking sexy. I think I gotta go Poetic Justice.
Yeah, I'm going Poetic Justice, man. I'm sorry.
I'm not even gonna fight. It's fine.
Dude, but Higher Power is so good. Don't get me wrong.
Higher Power.
A really hard pick for me.
Alright, what's next?
You ain't gotta lie in chapter 10.
You ain't gotta lie to kick it.
You ain't gotta lie.
You ain't gotta lie.
I think Butterfly is just better.
Yeah, I'm just going You Ain't Gotta Lie.
Than anything off Section 80, but...
What do you think, Kevin?
I'm not gonna even fight. I don't even know this.
Sorry, bro.
I love Kevin, bro. Okay, Untitled 2 or Element? So that's... do we need to play Untitled 2?
Untitled 2 is better than Element, bro. That's also what All Right is interpolated from. All Right is literally interpolated from. Oh my God.
Here, I'll just let you play it. I'll let you. Pimp, pimp!
Hey. It's a really slow build up. Pimp, pimp! I'm sick and tired of being tired. Can't pick a side to Gemini. Prophesize if we live or not. Get down on the floor. Said it won't be long. I see jiggle moves.
Do you need to play more?
No,
and do you need Element or not?
No, I don't need Element.
Oh shit, Kevin, what are you? See, I don't know, bro.
I like Untitled 2 here.
You like Untitled 2 more
than
Element?
Yeah, I do. Yes! That's what I'm talking about.
I don't know where my vote went, to be honest.
I don't think.
But,
I'm not a big fan of Element.
You guys outvoted me. Even if I did vote for Element, which,
yep.
I'm gonna be honest, I think I probably would have. It's okay.
Because I think...
That's okay.
Elements
okay,
2...
It's okay. I love Elements.
Element doesn't sound as interesting as Untitled 2. And the subject matter isn't
as deep
either.
I think just seeing Element live, like, gave me some bias.
Okay, fair. Fair. Yeah. And he doesn't perform this at all.
But I really like Element, dude. It's a good shout out to Element. All
right.
So these guys are haters, but I do like Element. Good song.
All right, we got like a minute to do the next song.
Okay, let's speed right. Right. Hey, let's just speed
right. Swing pulls.
So swing pulls
for free.
I even
for
this
free.
Dick ain't
free.
Free.
Yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Anyway,
it
we're
is.
Back.
Well, Calvin got reminded of for free, and
finally,
and I thought
it was the better track. Swing pulls.
No.
I mean, Swimming Pools is a cool, it's a fun party song.
Anti-drinking anthem.
Yep, even though he's talking about diving into a pool of liquor and then...
No, For Free just sounds better.
For Free is way better.
Productions.
For Free is way better, bro.
Probably the most jazzy song in the album.
Yeah, and it's on a jazz album.
And it's an interlude, what? All
right, now we're at...
God and Fear?
God
it's
and fear.
Fear. I don't like God, bro.
I like God.
Oh, I do too, I'm Catholic. But
no. Well, yeah, of course, but not like that. Like the song. I like the song. This one got me like.
Oh, wait.
Yeah.
I like Fear. But Fear is just like a top 5 Kendrick song for me, bro.
Fear is really good. Fear is probably
like
top 5.
I just want to like gaze at sunset real quick.
So. Oh, it's really bright.
It's so beautiful.
Can I show the camera?
Yeah.
Give them a show.
Wait, just your hands are kind of dirty. I don't know if that'll help with the grease.
Okay, whatever.
Alright,
sorry, Max. No, I'll
unfortunately, you guys will be missing the beautiful sunset.
That was a really, really good
cool waddle, bro.
Okay.
Where are we at? Yeah, Fear is a much better song than God.
I agree.
Alright.
Fear is a much better song. A much better song.
Alright, what we got next?
We got Mirror and United in Grief.
United in Grief. Easy.
Yeah, United in Grief.
Do you need
I like Mirror. I like Mirror though.
I do, but I also like United and Grief a lot, so I don't know if I'll like Mirror.
She woke up early. She woke up.
I choose
the
me, I'm sorry.
The day, the
bitch, don't kill my vibe or
Duckworth. Duckworth. Easy.
Duckworth. See, there you go. There you go. Duckworth. Yeah. Easy. What about you, Calvin?
Duckworth
yes.
is one of the. Wait.
Yes.
Wait. Have you heard? Okay, we'll refresh you later. We'll refresh you later.
I'm just gonna agree with y'all right now.
Okay. Yeah, good kid.
Yes, bro.
Good kid.
Yes,
wait, are you actually choosing y'all over good kid?
Yeah, bro. Why?
Are you serious?
I
look at D, bro.
Don't think good kid is as strong.
What?
On good kid, Mad City.
Good kid is such a great track. What? Dude, good kid is hard. Dude, it's good kid.
Yo, did you up there? Holy
it's
God.
Good kid. It's good kid, bro. Yaw is like Yaw. I don't know. Yaw is like one of the weaker cuts on Damn, bro.
I agree,
bro.
Dude, Damn overall is a weaker cut.
Good
weaker,
kid,
yeah,
bro.
Album.
Good kid is just so good. What?
No, I do like the sounds on Good Kid a lot more too, though.
And you know who produced that?
Massimation, baby.
Pharrell Williams produced that.
Ill Education, baby.
It's good kid. It's good kid. It's good kid.
What if right. What if we both say Yaw?
Yeah. Bro,
just even though I'm playing. No, I think
it's
good kid is way better. Yeah,
Yaw's kind of
like,
annoying.
Yaw's a lot like God, right? Where it's just like yeah.
Yeah, I'm not too into Yaw, to be honest. It's a little too slow for me.
Yeah, Yaw's weaker for sure. Yeah, I like your kid a lot. Hey, bro, you
it's
hate
done.
That sound.
It's fucking done.
Alright.
No, I don't. I just love good kid. Shout out for real.
Alright, shout out for
wait,
the
on.
Additional wings.
Woo! Let's play some basketball on Friday.
Sure.
It's been a minute. Gladcore.
Right now?
And what's without the bracket?
Oh shit, bro. There's 5% of battery! Okay, yeah, I'm gonna get my charger. Okay, we can do that another time then.
Okay, real quick, okay. So good kid.
It's good kid.
Sorry, Kevin. Yeah, good kid's a way better song.
Shout out to the Neptunes.
Whether I'm sober or...
Sorry, Calvin.
I really don't care.
So sorry, Calvin.
Don't
wait,
honestly.
Open the air fryer. I'll wait.
Mother, I'm sober and feel.
Wrong.
Guys, what are we doing? Mother, I'm sober or feel?
Talk about your mother.
Do you guys need a refresher?
I do.
Feel.
What do you want?
Praying for me.
What do you want for?
Probably.
You need mother, I'm sober.
Probably Mother, I'm Sober.
I like Feel. a little better. Feel's.
I was gonna say Feel, not gonna
a
lie.
A deeper cut on
I think Feel is like, he's also like really like stripping himself apart in this song.
And I think the production's better too.
Mm. Yeah.
It's like, yeah, you have like a very, very emotional track on both of them, but the production's better.
I'm going back to Feel more, yeah, too, if I'm being honest. Just like,
and Feel also like matches the atmosphere of the album more. Mother of Silver sticks out a little bit on this song. Yeah.
All right, we'll go Feel.
I Feel.
You Feel.
I Feel.
You see?
I do.
All right, what do we got here?
F, bro. Humble and Wesley's theory.
Wesley's theory.
Wesley's theory. Yeah.
F, humble, bro.
My last quote just went viral.
Dude, shout out to Justin if you're watching this video, because one of his first memories of me is me singing Humble and this one app called House Party.
Show me something natural like Afro on Richard Pryor. Show me something natural like Astro.
Savior or Count Me Out.
Ooh, what?
Count me out.
Okay.
Mr. Morale, give me high five.
I'll leave my silence.
Damn, you were gonna say Savior, huh? You like that Baby Keem influence?
Are you happy for me?
Really?
No, fuck.
Are you happy for me?
I don't like it as much as Count Me Out. I didn't count
me out. No. Putting my bias aside.
I love when you count me out.
Count me out. Count me out is better. Yeah, count me out is better.
Next.
Savior's my rusty. Savior's my rusty.
Oh, that makes sense. Yeah,
that's why I'm leaving my silence.
Oh, I'm sorry, bro. I'm really sorry about that.
Oh.
But think about it. And I'm tripping.
And I get me tripping. Stumbling.
Exactly.
Okay. Poe Man's Dreams and Backseat Freestyle. It's not a
freestyle.
All my life I want money and power.
I respect my mind or die from lead shower.
Alright, let's go. Tammy's song and King Kunta. I don't even need to. I don't need to listen to Tammy's song to tell you that King Kunta is better.
Yeah, King Kunta is so much better. So if it's King Kunta versus Wesley's theory, that's gonna.
I got a bone to pick.
Oh my god.
Is King Kunta like one of your favorites on T-Pab? Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's hard not to pick a favorite on T-Pab.
Is it like in your top three?
It's five, maybe.
Okay.
Alright, Hole Up or Mad City?
Mad City.
Mad City.
No question.
That's the first time either of them are up, and we're just gonna discount Hole Up like that. I know it's going against Mad City.
Dude, Mad City's arguably. It's up there.
Got me down by the end of the song.
Sing like the whole city
go against me.
So every time I'm in the street, I hear yeah.
Man down. Where are you from?
No, you're good. I think Hold Up's a good like recap song if you think about it.
Yeah. That's a good song.
It feels like a, you know.
Oh, like a recap song.
Yeah. You recollect in life and you're like, oh.
Yep. Hold up. I wrote this record
dude,
with 30,000
so
feet in the air. Steward is complimenting me on my nappy hair.
It sounds like you're recapping about, you know, like.
Fucking her in front of all of these passengers. They're probably thinking
he's a terrorist. Eat my asparagus.
I can't sleep on
can
Hold Up like that.
Dude, I just think Mad City's like a perfect song, man. I'm sorry.
I think Mad City's awesome at a concert.
Man. Yeah, he performed it.
Hold Up wouldn't be as crazy at a concert.
No. Dude,
Hold Up would.
I just wish. He doesn't play the second part of Mad City. Oh, wait, no, you go ahead.
Think about this, right? If you go
to Switch,
in California's of your college life and you put Hold Up on it, you will start shedding a tear.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
But, I think so. If you're at a concert and you don't know Mad City, you get the fuck out of there, bro, because it's the anthem for his concert.
That's true. Dude, I'll be honest, bro.
Yeah.
I wish he performed the second part. The second part I like even more. Right. I like even more than the first part.
Get your punk ass.
Yeah,
dude.
I don't know what you said.
Right. Reach out to school because I was a high school grad.
Okay.
Alright, so, sorry, Hold Up. Mad City's just really
Purple Hearts and Absolute Outro.
Absolute Outro.
Remember that was,
I'm not a big fan of Purple Hearts, guys.
One of the weaker ones.
Even though Ghostface Kill is on it, it wasn't executed.
Dude,
the production is not as good.
No, I think Ghostface did a good job, but I didn't like Summer Walker's part.
Exactly, I didn't like Summer Walker's
part. Dude, the most romantic line in that whole album is like, it ain't love if you ain't eat my ass. Like,
get out of here, yeah.
Okay, how much a dollar costs in Worldwide Steppers?
How much a dollar costs? Worldwide Steppers is an interesting beat. I think it's one of the weaker ones off of Mr. Morale and the Steppers.
How much a dollar costs is...
Dude, he goes up to a hobo and they stare at each other.
God,
I stare at him and he stares back at me. And now I'm noticing that his staring is contagious because now I'm staring back at him. Oh my god, bro.
Stop staring at me, man.
Your stare is contagious because now I'm staring back at you.
And I'm staring back at you. And I'm staring at Migs and...
I am God.
Oh!
It's really good because it captures how faith plays a very big part in Black culture.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. Easy. Easy, yeah.
Easy.
What do we got?
I don't think we need to, shout out to Lil Yachty.
Mm-hmm. Ronald Reagan.
Lil
Yachty. Who saw this?
Okay, Ronald Reagan era, Black of the Berry. Black of the Berry.
We're far from good enough.
Do you need a refresher?
I need a refresher for Ronald Reagan.
20 miles per hour down, come to Boulevard. With a cap down, drinking, we don't give a fuck.
For Tyler Creator, do you guys need a lot of refreshers, or like you guys need most of this?
Yeah, we need a refresher for Bastard
and Goblin. Yeah, almost all refreshers. And Cherry Bomb.
What was it? We're far from good, not good from far. 90 miles per hour
down, come to Boulevard. It feels like something Chris would like. It's just the beginning. is he like all
of that? Bro, you're such a mood, bro.
But the song changes a lot. He was in the line back then.
Whoopty whoop, whoopty
whoop. Should we go? So are we going Ronald Reagan or
go Black of the Berry, bro?
Emancipation of a real. I'm going the Black of the Berry.
Black of the Berry is way better. I'm sorry. Black of the Berry
I'm
has
sorry,
to be...
Chris. I can't defend you.
Black of the Berry is...
Do you have something else to say to Chris, by the way?
Shout out Chris. He's a fabulous individual.
Okay. Cool guy.
Silent Hill or Money Trees? Money Trees for me?
Money Trees. Yeah. Money Trees. That's
push
a classic.
Push these brothers off me like who? Push these brothers
money,
off
money
me
Trees
like,
is a
who?
Classic,
pushing
man.
The streets, I'm pushing the streets. Wait, Kodak Black is on Silent Hill, though.
DNA or Untitled One?
Fine.
Bro, what's Untitled One?
DNA.
Hold on. I wasn't necessarily gonna say Auntie's Diaries can go past, but I really like Auntie's Diaries. Oh yeah, let me say it. I think someone already has the answer.
Auntie's Diaries.
I
gotta really like listen to Auntie's like.
The production on Auntie's Diaries I really like. The story is really like vulnerable, but Untitled 7 is better. Yeah.
The production reminds me of The Art of Peer Pressure.
I like how it builds up at the end, and only because you let a white girl say.
That's like my least favorite part because like I wish it was longer that build up, you know, so there was like it's not
nothing.
Yeah.
I'm like, kind of with you on that. Like
it's like exponential. It just shoots up. Anyways,
no, but
yeah.
It sounds great, bro.
Alrighty, so now we made it to these walls, which I... Wait, no, Untitled 5 and Father Time.
Oh, sorry. Untitled 5 and Father Time. Father Time.
Father Time. Father Time.
Yeah.
Song filler.
Okay. Alright, so...
Early morning, wake up, practicing, I'm there.
Wait, it was these the walls versus what?
Fuck Here and See?
Untitled. Oh, Fuck Here and See. Oh, these walls.
These walls for sure, but... Fuck Here and See. Hello, hi. How you doing? Do you want a carrot?
Sorry?
Do you want a carrot or celery?
Or chicken.
No.
Oh, alright.
Okay. You're doing... Oh, okay. Laundry. Okay.
Yeah, these walls are just too sexy of a song. You can't go wrong with it.
It's these walls.
Yeah.
So, I need to listen to these walls. You guys have been hyping it up.
Coven just discovered these walls, and we told them about the triple entendre, possibly quadruple entendre.
Possibly five.
About the walls of a vagina, the walls of society, the walls of a prison, and the walls of the story.
Dude, the bracket's gone.
It's gone?
Oh, there we go.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Oh, that's scary.
Oh, wait. Oh, it's gone, bro.
It's gone. Oh, it's back.
Okay, cool.
Oh, it's gone.
F, bro. What's going on?
Oh, it's back. Oh, it's gone.
Why is it doing that?
I know what I'm doing.
I love being...
Actually, the wise... Oh, hey, there it is. Okay, cool. So it was what? These walls versus what?
Oh, fuck you, Anthony. No way. Oh, we're good. No.
No.
No! Wait, hold on, just go to history. History. Right?
You can... I don't know, bro. I don't know if it'll save the cash, to be honest.
Hopefully. There we go. 603?
Yeah.
603.
Oh, let's go.
I mean, is it? No, you can't edit this, though. What's that?
Let's go for it.
History.
We got history. Got me feeling the...
Yeah! Okay. Yeah.
Okay, we're safe.
Cool. All right.
So we almost deleted the bracket.
Now we... Just kidding. All right. Let's do this. All right, these walls wins. Fuck your ethnicity.
Yeah, I don't even
move it
to
over. Move it over.
Fuck that song.
He said, "Fuck that song."
All right, love versus rich spirit.
Love,
love. But rich spirit's really good, and I like the colors in the music video, man.
Love.
Rich.
Untitled 3 and Rich Interlude.
Trying to keep the
probably Untitled 3.
Yeah, Untitled 3. Rich Interlude's kind of goofy with Kodak talking about.
Okay. Where's that? I'm okay.
Sing about me. I don't even need to see the other song.
Savior Interlude is.
I don't need to see the other song.
As good, not nearly as good.
I like Savior's Interlude.
Yeah, but compared to Sing About Me.
Yeah.
All right.
So
what
now
we
we've reached round.
All right, start on top. I don't even need to see the. Let's start on top. Sing About Me goes by. I don't care who it's going against. No, I'm just kidding. I will
it
care. I'll care in the later rounds.
It
I'll
is
title
three though, so yeah, you can eat, Sing About Me. Definitely no. You're joking. It's okay. We understand.
No, I see the next round.
Yeah, I know.
It's Sing About Me, though.
Can we skip that one and go back to it? All right, so Sing
About
Me.
Just put Sing About Me next. Sing About Me
and
versus Untitled 3.
Father Time versus Untitled 7.
Wait, hold on.
That's why I was like, bro, don't start from the top. It's going to make it way worse.
Dude, oh my gosh.
Sing About Me, yay. Okay, cool.
Wait, can I plant the seeds for Sing About Me just like you did for These Walls?
Sure.
So there's no one-sided bias on this?
Sure.
Okay, good. Because, no, I mean, I do like These Walls, too.
All right, here, let's just scroll down.
Love versus These Walls.
Fine, okay, it's These Walls.
It's These Walls, yeah.
Because Love actually...
All right, let's go down, let's go down.
Kendrick's singing performance on Love isn't as good, but I really mess with Love, dude.
I mess with Love, too. Okay, go to the bottom.
Oh, no, wait, we can keep going, because I thought that was, like, the right one.
I think we can keep going. Father Time and Untold... Father Time,
yeah.
One of the best songs. It's probably the best song in... It's the best song on Father to on Big Steppers.
Arguably,
top three,
yeah, top like five.
And 95 exists too.
The best.
DNA, money trees, money trees,
money trees, money trees for me.
Oh, me and my trying to get it, you bitch. Hell yeah.
The black or the berry, and how much a dollar costs?
The black or the berry.
Probably the black or the berry.
Yeah, yeah, I agree. Cool. I agree.
Yeah, it's a really close cut, but I think the black or the berry has a lot more energy.
Yeah.
Outro.
No.
Mad City.
Mad City finally beats Absol's intro. There you go. Yep. Yeah.
All right. Okay, so now.
King Kunta
or Backseat Freestyle?
King Kunta. Come on.
Bones or pig?
King Kunta's way better.
I don't want you monkey mouth motherfucking sitting.
I think it's King Kunta.
It's King Kunta.
Exactly.
I like
it's not a shallow.
Okay, either. And then the next one, I'm going to put What's His Theory.
Is Backseat Freestyle supposed to just be him missing
Count me
around
out,
with his friends?
What's His Theory?
What's His Theory?
Come on.
Dude, this next round's
What's His Theory is incredible. That the bass,
now, what's going to win over here, though?
George Clinton?
Okay, Feel versus Good
Kid. From Funkadelic? Y'all don't even know, bro. Get the F out of here. Okay, anyways. All right. Feeling good,
tickle. It's Good Kid. Actually, no. I don't really care.
I don't really care.
We can go Feel. That's fine.
Feel.
Yeah, Good Kid's one of the weaker tracks on Good Kid, Mad City, but that's hard to say because it's like a really, really good album. All
right, and now we got.
It's probably like Fear, Real, or Compton, Swimming Pools, and then Good Kid.
Duckworth and United. Duckworth.
Oh,
you said?
No.
Duckworth. Duckworth is what? Duckworth is. Okay, Coven, we're gonna have to refresh you, bro.
You refresh my Duckworth? I have United Group for having enough.
You find
wait, okay. So let me do some implanting of what Duckworth is. Duckworth is a story about how, like, you know, growing up, like, his dad was working in, like, a fast food place.
Cool.
A chicken spot, right?
Just like
but there was this one, like, big gangster at the time who's Top Dog, Anthony Top Dog.
Yes, like my brother.
Uh-huh. Who actually ended up being the manager for Kendrick in the future.
That's my brother.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh.
That's crazy.
And then so basically this guy would always be like shooting people and like robbing people, right?
Yeah.
But
yeah.
But Kendrick's dad kind of like respected him because he's like, hey bro, I'm gonna give you some free chicken. I'm gonna give you like free chicken and all that.
Literally, what were you?
If you don't kill me and you don't like, you know, like stuff like that, and because of that, Kendrick was able to get a whole rap career,
mm-hmm.
But if his dad like was like refusing to like let himself get robbed, then he would have got killed, and then that means Kendrick would have had no father growing up,
mm-hmm.
And then he'd just be on the streets with no father figure,
mm-hmm.
And then he'd get killed himself.
Mm-hmm.
But here, let me play the song for you. No, I'm gonna play the beat switch.
Oh,
Yeah, I'm just gonna go to the first verse. Darling, I told you that my
Lamar. Hail Mary, she never won at times have been hard. Press first meal, 20 years old, had a couple of babies. Had a couple of shooters, caught a murder case. Fingerprints on the gun, they're assuming, but witnesses couldn't prove it. That was back when he tapped his back and they killed his cousin. Let me know when you need when you're good.
I think I'm good. What's your pick?
Dude, it's the best track on, in my opinion, on Mr. Mel and the Big Steppers, and the best track on Damn.
It's really hard for Duckworth.
I'm not unhappy about that, but Jesus Christ, dude. United in Grief, though, really has, like...
No. I love United in Grief.
I agree, the piano.
I agree.
Really good. But
and then Duckworth the sound, the production is actually way... Yeah. Oh, No.
I'm gonna have to stop you there. Duckworth is, like...
The best produced, I think, Kendrick
song. Yeah, the best produced Kendrick song, like, arguably ever.
It's up there with, like, Wesley's Theory.
Can I go?
Fuck. I just can't even... The sounds, though, on United in Grief is just too much.
Yeah, Fear and For Free.
I think For Free. Fuck.
It's For Free, but it's Fear, for free. I like Fear better.
Really?
I like Fear better, but it's objectively For Free.
For Free is an interlude.
Actually, no,
wait.
Let's go back. See, my vote would personally be Fear.
Me too.
Yeah, sure.
So let's bring it in the forward. Okay, good. Yeah. I thought you were going to say For Free.
Yeah, no. Fear.
Okay, good.
I was like, wait a minute.
Good. Dab me up. Yeah, I'm sorry. I know you love that track, Kevin.
Yeah.
But Fear is like a 12 minutes, like a 7 minute song with him, like rapping about his fear from when he was a kid.
Yep.
His fear when he was a teenager.
Yep.
And Fear currently in 2017 at the time. And
you should do Fear round two.
Yeah.
Fear
wait,
is just
wait, look, so let me, look, wait, wait. I'm just gonna play the instrumental.
Fear is incredible.
Okay, I thought you were gonna say for
Snob.
I was gonna. Come on. No. Fear is like my favorite song on Fear's Duckworth are my two favorite songs in Dan. Yeah, I mean it's basically this instrumental loop the whole time. Okay. We'll come back to it. Untitled 2 and You Ain't Gotta Lie.
You Ain't Gotta Lie.
You Ain't Gotta Lie to Kick It. Yeah, it's Untitled.
Because it's like
it's You Gotta
Lie. It's a full song versus an unmastered song that didn't make the album. So You Ain't Gotta Lie. Like, and it just sounds better, too, so.
Well, you can't necessarily say that, but, like...
That literally is it, though.
I mean, I'm not with that logic, but, like, I mean, there's some songs in Untitled, but, you know.
I don't think any song on Untitled or Mastered is better than any song on To Pimp Butterfly at all.
Okay, that's fair.
That's my opinion.
That's fair. No, I agree.
And it makes sense. Neither did
Tendrick, I mean, yeah,
so.
Yeah.
Poetic Justice or...
Rigor Mortis? Poetic Justice.
Yeah, I go Poetic Justice. Mm-hmm. I go Poetic Justice. Okay.
Sorry, Kevin.
Well,
we know you like your horns.
Mm-hmm.
I
love myself.
It's I.
I versus institutionalized. It's I.
It's I. You agree, Kevin?
I agree too.
Yep.
We'll speed run these. Okay. Art of Peer Pressure and All Right. It's All Right. It's All Right.
All Right. All Right.
So it's All Right.
Even though I love, yeah. All
right. N95 are you?
N90. Oh no! It's you. It's you.
It's you.
It's you. It's you. It's you. It's you. It's
you.
You
were not about to say N95 over you, bro. Get out.
No. I was on brain fart mode. Use his best. One of his best songs.
Mm-hmm.
You and All Right.
Let's go back to that one.
No. Or do you want to go? Or do you want to go Sing About Me and Or did you want to do Sing About Me in These Walls first, bro?
Oh.
Go start in the bottom. Start in the bottom, Kevin.
Fuck, you're
start
right.
Start in the bottom. Start in the bottom, bro.
Okay, so I think all of these Kendrick songs right now, for sure, are his best. Like these.
Yeah.
That like.
Okay.
Fuck.
What I will have for All Right. Okay, you like writing wise is better. But production wise, not production. I didn't mean to say production. Like, culture wise, was such a big thing.
The cultural impact.
Yeah. But if we're excluding like just the cultural impact and we're just looking at it as a song, then I think you is better.
Mm-hmm. You also has a beat switch, different flow delivery.
Mm-hmm.
He's got sound effects.
It's Kendrick's most vulnerable song, bro.
And he did it. He wrote it after he went on tour with Kanye West.
I can vote for you.
You like you remember you and everything?
Yeah.
Okay, we can go you. We'll go you. Sorry, All Right. I love
Dude,
All Right.
It's so hard. Wow, that was just too quick.
Right. I didn't make it that
all
far.
Right. All Right is so fucking good. Fuck. But you was just
No,
edges it out.
All right.
You is probably for me the best song on that album. Like objectively speaking.
I think not, objectively speaking. But.
All right.
Oh, actually, no. It's Wesley's Theory or you. But anyway, for me, it might be you.
Yeah, for sure.
If you're more into the writing, I think it's you.
You're writing?
Boy Justice or I?
I.
If
it's gonna be I versus you.
Okay, what are you gonna say, Kevin?
I like I.
Okay.
You like poetic justice, or
I'll leave my vote silent.
No, but like, just say it.
I like poetic justice, man. It's a classic for me.
I think I is better. And it's not as
I like poetic justice more, but I think I is better.
I think poetic justice is a little more of a shallow topic, and it's not his first time talking about sex, you know.
Yeah, but this is also no like the perspective of him is like a teenager, you know. So
I know, but like, all throughout Duke and Mad City, he's talking about like, you know, 17 with nothing but pussy stuck on my mental. Mm-hmm. Like, that's just his thing. I get it.
Where's Shireen?
Did we forget, dude? Did you forget Shireen, bro?
No, I think we vote. Do we not vote? Did we not vote it already? We might have done it.
Bro, we didn't do Shireen, bro.
It's okay.
Wait.
Because Shireen is better than I. And we didn't do
it's okay.
F. Oh, F, bro.
F,
oh, maybe instead of GKMC.
It was Shireen. Oh.
Wait, hold on. Let's see if that would have changed anything first off.
Totally would have.
Wait, let's see.
It's like,
it's okay. It's whatever.
Oh, wait, King Kunta versus.
Oh, no. King Kunta would have won. Wow. I'll be honest.
Yeah, King Kunta would have won.
Okay, no, it wouldn't have changed anything, guys. Don't worry.
But barely. Barely. Shireen is the best intro, I think.
It's his best intro.
No, it's not. Because then there's Wesley's theory.
Wesley's theory is objectively versus.
And there's United and Grief. Bro.
I like Shireen better.
I can't pick, dude. Oh, my battery's about to die. All right, let's do.
Stop scaring the house.
What? Oh shit.
Stop scaring the house.
Stop scaring the house.
Fuck is that?
Danny Brown.
Stop here
now! Stop here now!
Alright,
let's go.
Okay. Start from the bottom, yeah.
Start from the bottom.
Alright, so we got
fear and you ain't gonna lie. It's fear. It's fear.
Wait, what? Why there and not feeling Duckworth or poetic? Wait, what? Oh, I'm stupid. Okay, sorry.
It's fear.
Yeah. It's fear.
Go fast with
the fear is definitely better, yeah. It's but fear. You ain't gonna lie. It's to be butterfly
track. Duckworth.
Duckworth.
Yes, thank you.
No, it's like,
easy.
It's actually hanged.
What do we got next?
Huh?
King Kunta.
Am I going with Wesley's theory here?
Me too. King Kunta versus Wesley's theory?
It's Wesley's theory.
I think it's just more orchestrated.
I'm voting for King Kunta for my boy Oppie, bro. I still remember at the concert, man, when we heard the little warping sound at the beginning, we both looked at each other instantly, and we're like, I got a bone to pick! But Wesley's theory is a better song.
I think, yeah, Wesley's theory is just impressive. Platinum on everything, platinum on Wedding Ring. The Black and the Berry versus Mad City.
Oh, Mad City.
What do you think, David?
You have an answer, though, I feel.
Yeah,
I think the Black or the Berry is the better song. Overall, the better instrumental, better messaging, better writing, better flow, better everything. But Mad City is way more iconic. That's the only thing it has.
I feel like both of the instrumentals in Mad City a little more than, or like at least as much than Black of the Berry, and a little more. I just feel like it's more captivating.
The Black of the Berry. Captivating.
It is a very captivating song. But Mad City's is more captivating, bro. You hear that shit, you're like, man, where are you from?
That is true. The silent and then the humming a little bit before the beat drops is iconic. But the Black of the Berry. Think about the lo-fi production, the African like chanting.
It's like a double concert bias. Lens and Mad City.
I went to fucking Mad City, or I saw Mad City live too, but like.
Not twice.
Shout out!
Man, fuck you, bro.
Yeah.
Hold on. Didn't you say like some shit?
No.
Were you voting for Hole Up over Mad City, bro? Get the fuck out of here. That's fine.
Wait, if it was Hole Up versus Sing About Me.
Wait, but hey, honestly, I think the Black of the Berry just goes into a deeper subject matter than it builds off of the subject matter already created by Mad City. So Mad City is like the OG, you know? Talking about like killing each other, even though like, you know, why would you do that?
Mad City's at that moment.
Yeah.
It's during the moment though.
Yeah, exactly. But the Black of the Berry.
Father Time and Money Trees.
Money Trees, for money sure. Trees. Money Trees is way more iconic.
Money Trees.
J-Rock is on there, Anna Wise is on there.
The J-Rock feature might be the best feature on a Kendrick song.
We were talking about this off camera.
Kevin, I feel like we both know a lot about both these songs. Why don't you talk about what you think?
Sing About Me and These Walls?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah.
So, I personally It was my first time listening to both of them today.
Really?
Yeah.
Wait, these are literally his best songs, bro.
Bro, what the hell? No, I should be slapping you, bro. What the hell?
Alright.
DEA!
I'm sorry.
Shit. He's also singing about me.
Huh?
So, I think Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst is probably my favorite song out of these two. It's just very heartfelt. I felt the emotions when I heard the gunshots and the... Just when you were describing like how like some of the ways the song was very analogous to like what he was going through within those moments were kind of crazy.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay.
I'm voting for Sing About Me. Before I let you talk about these walls.
I mean,
for me, I'll talk about Sing About Me really quick. Man, who else raps in three different perspectives like at that level? Man, you know, he's rapping about, about Keisha's sister. He's rapping about his friend's brother, who just died. Mm-hmm. He's rapping about, his own perspective. Mm-hmm. And then the beat switches to the dying of thirst. Like, if you think that the beat switch part is better than the first part, like, I'm not even, mad, man. Dude, it's crazy that Good Kid, Mad City has two of the best, beat switch songs.
Mad City and Sing About Me.
And I just think, it's his most personal track.
Yep.
It feels like the lights are shining on him and it's like him just reflecting.
Yeah.
But yeah.
It's a perfect summary of everything he's ever done, and he brings in the religious aspect into it. You know, if they get baptized or they accept Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, it's not like their physical baptism, but it is like their metaphorical baptism. You know, when they accept Jesus Christ into their life, the next step is just to get baptized to decree to the world. You'll be baptized and you'll follow Jesus in the world of sin. But
so, did you have anything to say about These Walls?
Because that's your favorite song.
Yeah, These Walls is by far my favorite song, which is hard to say because now it's going against Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst. But, I mean, These Walls, I think I have to be in a certain mood to listen to Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst. And if I listen to it, I'll be brought down to that mood and I'll be like, shit, that was heavy, you know? These Walls is really funky, it's really groovy, and, you know, we talked about it already. Migs mentioned a triple entendre, I mentioned a triple entendre, but we had one thing that wasn't overlapping, so it could even be a quadruple entendre. There's the walls of a vagina, there's the walls of society, there's the walls of
a prison,
and then there's also possibly the walls of a story he's telling. So quadruple entendre, it sounds really, really good. It's one of his most unique sounding songs too.
Shout out Thundercat.
And he talks about, you know, or he has the poem continuing and it makes perfect sense where it's stationed. So
Yeah.
It just sounds so fucking good. It sounds too fucking good. But Sing About Me, I mean, I'm not unhappy that it's moving on. So let's do it.
I think I'm gonna text you, by the way.
Yeah,
people, I'm getting so many texts. Alright, okay, let's finish this off before the camera dies.
Mad City's theory, what's the theory?
Wesley's theory is better than Mad City.
In my opinion, I think it had to lose.
I think Wesley's theory is objectively
I love Mad City more, but I'm personally... But objectively, I can't lie if I'm Wesley's Theory is a better song.
I like Wesley's Theory better, personally, too. So, personally and objectively, I think it's
better. Well, the instrumentals,
Same.
Atmosphere.
Same.
When a yes sign, homie, I'm alive. Duckworth and Fear.
Duckworth, come on, get out of here.
No. I don't care which one goes by. I like both equally.
Duckworth's instrumental is better.
Shout out Ninth Wonder.
Yep, Ninth Wonder.
It's Duckworth. I feel like Duckworth is a more. Yeah, I'm kind of with you. I do need to be in a mood for Fear.
And it defines his whole fucking career, his whole fucking life.
I did listen to Fear during some sad times.
Yeah,
it did get me through that. But Duckworth is just a fucking epic track.
Yeah,
it's. The better storytelling cut. I think the beat is better. The beat switch is pristine. The by the dawn's early light.
Not quite.
What's so?
Alright, just pick Duckworth, bro.
Would you say Duckworth?
Yeah.
Okay.
Hell yeah! Alright, Duckworth. Let's see what we got here, guys. It's about to.
It's you.
You is better than I. Sorry about that.
Sorry, Kevin. I know
very,
you like,
very much.
You just. He's like, okay, whatever.
All right, what do we got next? We missed one, cool. I think.
We did.
I think we missed one.
We did not miss any.
It's Sing About Me versus.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. It's Sing About Me.
Sing About Me is better than Money Trees, for sure.
It's Sing About Me.
For sure. Even Though Money Trees is my favorite off the album.
Oh, man,
I think Sing About Me is just way better.
It's
although I will never listen to Sing About Me like on like
repeat
on repeat for sure.
I mean, I would.
You
shit.
Would?
Yeah, I would. All right, Wesley's theory. And,
oh, we'll come back to that.
All right, semifinals.
Duckworth versus you. This is a hot.
These are actually like, including these walls, these are my top five right here. Literally right here. Sing About Me, Wesley's Theory, Duckworth, you, and these walls.
Okay. So we got, so we're in the semifinals, right?
I'm happy.
So we have semifinals. We have Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst, and Wesley's Theory. And then the other side, there's Duckworth versus you. We'll start with Duckworth versus you.
You.
Kevin, what do you think? Wait, do you need a refresher?
Let's do a refresher of the next four songs.
Okay. Right, here, pause let's pause it. Yeah, okay.
Channel it down.
Any last words before we pause it?
A shout out to Anthony.
And shout out to Martin Luther King.
Because those boys had a dream. And fuck David.
All right, guys. What are we thinking? Duckworth versus you. Duckworth versus you.
Okay, I'm going to be the media critic. Because Coven actually, it seemed like he really liked both of these songs.
Yeah.
I want to hear what you're thinking first before like either of us make an answer. I'm the mediator for this one.
That sounds good to me.
Because I could go either way with this one, to be honest.
This is really tough.
Talk it out.
I think... Hey, boys and girls.
Talk to him.
So, when I was... I think Duckworth was probably, like, a song I'm leaning closer towards. It's just, like... to me, personally, I thought it was, like, a more, like, emotional song in the whole story of...
I'm just reacting. Dude, Keep going, bro.
Covid is pissed about your reaction. Oh,
okay,
you're
coming.
Yeah,
go on.
Okay. No, I don't hate you. I don't know what that. Anyway, I don't know. Like, I just, it was just really cool to just have him share like a very like personal story of his with, especially with, regarding his dad and what his dad's been through, and then like how like if things were different, if this one dude was, if he ended up killing his dad at the chicken store, like, if that actually happened, then, like, he wouldn't be where he's at, you know? But, like, just the way he's, like, kind of, like, constructed it, and, like, I don't know, it's a really good track, is, yeah, but then there's also you, and then you sounds awesome, it's really good, and... yeah.
You keep getting quieter, bro. That's why I put it.
I know.
Okay, all right.
All right, I'm a little tired.
I'll talk less. No, I guess you. The beat switch on Duckworth is heavenly, dude.
Yeah.
Shout out Ninth Wonder.
So beautiful. I do want to say though that the beginning and the end with the Kung Fu Kenny like interludes are kind of annoying. In general, like I don't like that in the whole damn album. I don't like when he's like, just remember what happens on Earth stays on Earth. And then I don't like that. We gonna put that in reverse. And then I don't like the end where they literally put it in reverse. It doesn't... I don't like the sonic elements of that. But, like, the song uh-huh. in Duckworth is near perfect.
I see.
So, there's that. But I'm rooting for you because I think it's more emotional. I think...
That's true.
The production is also, like, really, really, really good. But, like, compared to Duckworth, it's lacking a little bit. But there's more panning, there's more effects, there's a distort. It sounds like you're literally listening to like music that's drunk because he's drunk, he's dealing with his problems. There's so many like sides to the story, and it's so emotional.
Like that.
It's so
emotional. I did that like the I don't know what's the right term where like he was like. It's hard to love your world. What was the line?
Loving you is complicated.
Yeah, but then he was like actually referring to himself. That mm-hmm. was like,
hey, that's incredible. Yeah.
Yeah,
like that's pretty tough.
Especially when portrayed in the music video, when he was looking at the mirror, I was like, damn, bro. Like,
yeah, it's beautiful. And then the beat switch happens, and then like he just beat the fuck up because he's too busy with it, chasing his life and his dreams that he doesn't care about his foundation and where he came from. You know.
Yeah.
All right, Migs, what do you think?
Well, what's your vote, Migs? This is like the...
I've had my actual answer.
All right, what is your answer? Bro?
Yeah, these are like two of like his best songs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, these are two of his best songs for sure. Especially on the writing side, like these are his like deepest cuts. like writing wise, I yep. think the performance in You is better. Yeah. But like in terms of like the vocal, the emotions he's portraying, but I think and as like a traditional hip hop song, I believe that Duckworth is superior. So it comes down to I know you didn't like the what happens under stay under loop in reverse. I fucking love that. Like
that was cool too. Yeah, I'll be honest. Like that.
Okay, this is an interview. I'm kidding.
That's what I was doing.
Yeah, but that's why I like that was like a little bit of a cherry on top of for me, to be honest.
Really?
Because like a traditional hip hop song, you know, would have those vocal lines like that. I do like the I don't know, that enhanced it even more. The put in reverse, I mean, you know, like the album Damn is supposed to be played in reverse, mm-hmm. like to get a different story.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought that was pretty freaking cool. But I don't know, like it's
mm-hmm. mm-hmm. All right, so Migs, so what do you think? So what do you think?
You or Duckworth?
Yeah, I do have my
answer. What's your answer?
All right, should I just say it?
Yeah, say it.
Bring it.
All right, close your eyes.
Why?
It'll be funny, just for the effect.
Oh, yeah, I'll get the auditory close.
It's Duckworth.
All right, so what was the answer? We have to know, too.
It's Duckworth.
Okay.
Duckworth is my favorite song off Damn.
Oh, ass, bro. Dom is calling me.
I think Duckworth, man. Duckworth is a...
Yeah.
I think Duckworth...
That's okay.
Duckworth...
Yes, bro.
Yes,
bro. So I'm not my bad. You, bro.
The only reason why you're picking Duckworth is because you know it's gonna be easy for Sing About Me to destroy Duckworth.
No, I wouldn't say that.
I'm playing. Yeah.
No, I think Duckworth and Sing... Well, we didn't even choose, like, the
No way.
Anyway, dude, Duckworth is probably like my favorite song on it's probably like one of my favorite Kendrick songs like ever. Like I just mm-hmm. no, it's like a very mindfuck song.
Like I said, the top five plus
I think well, it's yeah. it's probably like it's arguably his best traditional hip hop song. Like I mean, like in terms of like I guess the stereotype of a hip hop song, you know.
Yeah. The production's wild. Isn't a very traditional hip hop song at all.
There's nothing wrong. I think You bends the genres.
It wouldn't even be called like hip hop. I feel like you could say. But anyways, yeah. I guess you're right.
It's Duckworth.
I'm okay with that.
I also love to piss off the audience, man.
I don't know if that pissed off the audience.
But I don't know.
We'll find out.
We'll see.
No. I will say this. If this was 2020, 2020 Migs would have had You winning the whole thing.
I still would have had you winning the whole thing, bro. Shit.
All right.
Except for these walls, but. Alright, Sing About Me versus Wesley's Theory. I think these are the objective best songs on each respective album.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm not doing none of that mediator shit. It's Sing About Me. It's Sing About Me for me. For me, like I'll say my grace, just in case you guys vote for... I know you guys both like Wesley's Theory. I'm gonna just say my case. You hear that and you don't and that you know classic is coming.
Alright.
His best rapping song, like that's his best like that's his like his most emotional song. His best it's his best song. It's like his best song ever. Why is that? As I said, different rapping perspectives. Production, it's you guys are voting for Wesley's Theory, I know.
Here, but think about it. What if you hear a record scratch and it's every brother is a star. Da, 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 da. Every brother is a star.
Wait, those are not actually the lyrics. Wait, I don't think those are the actual lyrics.
You can say the lyrics. Go ahead.
Well, I mean, I'm not gonna say it because I want Sing About Me to Die of Thirst to win, bro. Dude, Sing About Me, Dying of Thirst is the best hip hop song. Like
when I get signed, homie, how does it go? Fuck, I just killed myself.
Just like the guy who got killed in Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst, bro.
Wanna get signed, homie, I'ma buy a strap.
Promise that you will sing about me. Promise that you will sing about me.
No. Wanna get signed, homie, I'ma buy a strap. Straight from the CIA, set it on my lap. Take a few M16s to the hood. Pass them all out on a plaque, what's good? Come on, bro.
What are you saying?
I'm not even voting for Wesley's Theory.
We're just screaming, bro. We're just screaming, bro.
Sorry, I don't know, dude.
I'm a little.
Bro, sorry. I'm putting this in your face.
It's a little conundrum here.
Because you know what side you're on, bro.
Because I'm.
Or do you know what side you're on?
I don't know what side I'm on.
It's Sing About Me. Like,
it's like, on, no, like, it's, I have to, like, sing it. Like, I love Sing About Me a lot. It's my first day listening to it.
Yep.
I love it a lot. I love Wesley's Theory a lot, but I love Sing About Me a lot.
Wesley's Theory, you've known longer than Sing About Me.
Yeah, I've known it for
But that doesn't mean it's, like, it has to be better.
Yeah, no, exactly, exactly.
You've had more time to digest it and really
process exactly, like, rather than Sing About Me, where I only have one listen.
If you knew, like
so it's almost hard for me to vote, I'll be honest.
Dude, it's over, bro.
They don't want to see us win, bro.
They don't want to see us win.
That was good.
Sing About Me versus Wesley's Theory.
It's Sing About Me, man. It's Sing About Me.
I think I have to agree. It was my first time listening to it. It was very emotional. It was very catchy, and I loved it.
Yeah. I'm going to go Sing About Me, too.
Really? Wait, are you serious?
I really like Wesley's Theory, but like Sing About Me is like by far...
Okay, good. By far we're finally going to get the right answer for this.
I just had to do
We're going
to
get the right answer for this bracket, guys.
I just had to do a devil's advocate for Wesley's Theory because it's such a good song.
Okay, you scared me like so hard. Like I was like, there's no way you actually all think right. that...
It is really good, though. And it also...
So it comes out of this.
Boys.
Wait, hold on.
The finale.
Okay. Coven, why don't you announce the finale?
So the finale is... Finale. The finale. The finale is Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst, and Duckworth.
And I think we all know how this is gonna end.
And yeah, it seems so kind of obvious. It's very obvious actually with the answer.
Yep. I think it's Martin Luther by Uno Miles.
Exactly. And don't forget Uno Mar.
Really like that song, bro. God damn. Okay.
Okay, you know, okay.
Don't forget
No.
Don't forget Ford Focus.
Don't forget Indiana Jones, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, we should do Indiana. We should do a...
Don't forget Michael Jordan.
We should do a Uno Miles bracket next.
Yeah, yes, sir. This should be really fun.
That'll be so funny, bro.
Don't forget. All right,
put this S down, bro.
Put it down.
Put this S down so we can see Coven's beautiful face.
Coven, do you want to announce what we're all thinking? Because I think... Are we all on the same page here?
I think we're on the same page.
All right, Coven, say who wins it all, bro.
The best Kendrick Lamar song... through this bracket that we've been through.
Yep.
Is. And put a drum roll, I guess.
Wait. Can I do the drum roll?
Go ahead.
I mean, you're already doing it, though.
When the lights go off and it's our time to settle down, the main concern, promise that you will sing about me. So we found the answer.
It's Duckworth.
It's Duckworth. Yeah.
It's Duckworth.
Right,
Duckworth.
Yeah.
It's Sing About Me. It's Sing About Me. I'm Dying of Thirst, guys. It's the best hip hop song ever.
It's actually the hardest part five.
It's the best. No, actually, it's.
Oh, yeah. I forgot to mention, we didn't do the hearts because there's too many of them. There's five.
There's five. There's too many. Yeah. Too many songs. We're missing a few other songs, I think.
Yeah, we didn't do Overly Dedicated and a couple singles and like.
But the winner is.
Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst.
Yeah.
What's the winner? Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst.
Sing About Me.
Sing About Me, I'm Dying of Thirst. Is the winner, bro.
I'm
yes.
Happy with that. That's
yes, sir. David is an S, bro. Makes fucking sucks. Alright, anyway. It's me. I'm a mystery man. I do my mystery things. Anyway, you guys see the moon?
Yeah?
They mooning.
Huh?
You guys see the moon?
Four corners of this moon collide. No, that song did not win.
Anyway. There we go. We're recording his...
His penis?
And then recording his...
Dude, I love how it started off as like a podcast thing. And now it's like,
and then it just became a very violent argument. No, I was about to kill everybody.
Coven is like hosting a porno, bro.
Oh, that too, yeah.
Hey guys, welcome to Coven's sexy talk.
Why is he talking all quiet?
What's
the final? Thanks for watching the video.
Get Coven in here, bro.
Thanks for watching the video.
Alright, so in the
we count
the chicken. So, one.
Oh,
two,
should we actually count?
Three.
Yeah.
Four, five. I'm done. All right. Peace, boys.
Woo! More than four. That's amazing.
Woo!
So what do you guys say about vegetables? Woo! Oh, yeah.
No. I love the vegetables. I'll eat them.
You guys want to see how many vegetables we ate? Count.
One, two,
three, four.
All right. Good shit, boys. More than four. That was some good work.
Wonderful. Amen.
Wonderful. Amen. Amen. Amen, brother.
All right.
All right. Welcome on to y'all, folks. That's hello, actually. All right. I hope you enjoy my bunda as I walk that way.
Where's he walking, bro? Here, let's narrate for him.
No, I just stopped the recording.
Just stop.